Hey guys, Evangelist Robb here of Robb Woods Ministries. I want to prophetically decree and declare to you, the government of the world, every government is upon his shoulders or his shoulder. God's not fretting. The Lord's not freaking. I think I said this yesterday. The father never told the son, hey, go down to the local pharmacy, get me some talcum powder. I'm a little concerned about what's going down there on that world I created. I am breaking out in a rash. Friends, God's still on the throne, no matter what the outcome of this election is. Now, I will say this, prepare yourself first spiritually, and it's not unwise to be over-prepared in the natural. Have some extra food. Make sure there's gas in your car. Why? Because there's protests that are probably going to erupt after the announcement of the winner. And today's Wednesday. It could be today. It could be a week. It could be 2 weeks. It could be dragged out till January, which I don't think. But it'd be an honor if you'd subscribe to the channel. Hit the like button. Specific prayer requests or comments can go in the comment section. I'm live every Monday, 9 p.m. Eastern, prophesying, preaching, praying, the word of the Lord, the hour of power now. I want to pray for you if you're losing hope and faith, if you're tired, you're weary, for strength in about 3 minutes, the impartation of the Holy Spirit. I want to take you into Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder. I'm going to say it again. And the government will be upon his shoulder. Friends, God raises up. God pulls down. God plucks down. God raises up. The Lord in the sovereignty in his filter knew before the beginning of time who was going to win the 2020 election. Now we always contend for justice, for righteousness, for biblical values. But if the person we thought we wanted to win doesn't, what do we do the day after? What do we do? Do we break out? Do we cry? Do we go in a pout? Do we go into a cave? Friends, we continue the work of the kingdom of God, which is simply the saving of souls and the discipleship of souls, the Great Commission. Our calling or ministry doesn't waver based upon any man or woman winning or losing a presidential election. Now, we honor presidents. We want to see the correct legislature being passed. But friends, the revival was never coming from the White House anyway, nor is it. The awakening, the outpouring, it's going to come from God's house. The people of God, his church, his called out ones, his remnant, his conduit, his extension, and his body. The body of Christ. Not that politics or the mountain of government is not important. It's certainly a key. Dear God, I prayed for three or four hours Monday. Praise the Lord, on and off, through different meetings and yada yada. But we're contending for the will of the Lord, or what we believe what would be the will of the Lord. But we don't break out in a rash. We continue with the ministry of the Lord. We go on. And the government will be upon his shoulder. His name will be called the Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end, upon the throne of David and over his kingdom. Friends, God is a God on a throne. He's not moved by man or woman. We're never even supposed to place our hope and trust in man or woman. Chronicles 20:20, I think it says, believe in the Lord your God. You shall be established. Believe his prophets and you shall prosper. Doesn't say believe in his prophets. It says believe his prophets. You don't put your trust, faith, or hope in any man or woman because they're fallible. You only put your place, your faith, hope, and trust in Jesus, in God. Hallelujah. That's why it says believe in the Lord your God, and you shall be established. Revelations 4:1, friends, God's still on the throne. Read about the throne. He's a judge. He's a king. He's a ruler. God Almighty on the throne. Father, I'm praying for people that may be despondent or upset that the candidate they didn't win or thought they were going to win. It gets upset or they're depressed or they lose faith and hope. Friends, our faith and hope was never in the president or man or woman anyway. You may have been viewing this show after the results already came in. I'm telling you, Jesus is alive. The kingdom of God's going to flourish. Yes, there's perilous times, Matthew 24. I'm not negating that are going to come. I've been warning people for 4 months. 3 months all over the world on different platforms about what God's been speaking to me or what I feel the Lord has been speaking to me. You could check it out on the shows. Hey, the Lord bless you. Subscribe to the channel. I'm live every Monday, 9 p.m. Eastern, New York, the hour of power, praying over you guys, prophesying the word of the Lord. The Lord bless you. Amen.